Hello children, how are you fine? Hope you are enjoying my video classes. And today, as per your choice, we shall be discussing to you the topic molecular basis of inheritance. And under this topic, we shall be handling today the subtopic regulation of gene expression and how the regulation of gene expression is being controlled in different level. One such level is the transcription level, where we shall discuss in detail about with the help of a lac operon model. So, as I told you that the regulation of gene expression is controlled in transcription level, in translation level, in movement or transport of RNA from the nucleus to the cytoplasm through the nuclear pore of the nuclear membrane. Now, with the help of a very suitable example, this experiment of lac operon controlling of gene expression was introduced for the first time by two scientists. One is Jacob and his associate Mohner. Jacob and Mohner, in a beautiful way, has explained the lac operon model, and we shall understand how the regulation is taking place. Now let us start. In the case of bacteria, these are experiments done on enteric bacteria, E. coli bacteria, where there is a regulatory gene and a structural gene. The structural gene here is a polycystronic gene having Z gene, Z, Y gene and A. These three genes together forms the structural protein through mRNA, and further action is taking place. And before the structural gene Z, Y and A component, we are having a operator region of the gene, then a promoter region of the gene and I gene. I gene here, I gene here does not mean for inducer, it means for inhibitor gene. It inhibits something. What does it inhibit? We shall discuss. Now let us see. Normally, the source of energy for bacteria as well as for other higher animals and plants also, instantaneous source of energy is glucose, because glucose is the monosaccharide which directly enters to the cell and oxidizes to produce energy. So glucose is the ready-made source of energy. Now what happened? When glucose is available in the medium, then this I gene, what we call I, is not the inducer gene, it is rather inhibit something. What does it inhibit? We shall just discuss now. Now, when the I gene is there, at what time I gene become active? When there is sufficient amount of glucose in the cell. Normally, glucose is the instantaneous source of energy. So when glucose is there, then the I gene, otherwise what you call inhibitor gene, it's acting as a regulatory gene. Regulatory gene, inhibitor gene I acts as a regulator gene. Regulator. It produces an mRNA. This mRNA is called a repressor mRNA. Why? Because it represses something by means of its translation process. What does it repress? This mRNA, repressor mRNA, produce a protein, what we call as a repressor protein. So this is the repressor protein. protein. This is a repressor protein. Repressor protein. Now, when this repressor protein is produced, this repressor protein will bind with the operator region of this structural gene. This operator region, when bind with the repressor protein, then the operator is blocked. Operator is blocked. What happened to the operator? Operator is now blocked. Operator is blocked. Now operator is not free. And when the operator is blocked, the mRNA, the promoter region is now not accessing the RNA polymerase enzyme. RNA pol. As we know, RNA polymerase enzyme, its function is to synthesize or transcribe mRNA. Now, when the promoter is not accessing the RNA polymerase, why it is not accessing the RNA polymerase? Why it is not getting the RNA polymerase enzyme? Because of operator is already tired. Its hands are tired. Operator is kidnapped by the, in my language I use the term kidnapped by the repressor. As a result, promoter is not accessing the RNA polymerase, hence no triggering of RNA synthesis, mRNA synthesis by the Z, Y and A structural component of gene. So no mRNA is synthesized, no mRNA, as this operator is booked. Operator is completely booked. Its hands are tied, not free. Now what happened? Why it has given a name lac operon? Because here lactose is a sugar which, when present in the medium, suppose there is less amount or lack of glucose. In that case, the alternate source of energy is lactose or allolactose. What is lactose? Lactose is a disaccharide. Lactose is a disaccharide. It is made up of one molecule of glucose plus one molecule of galactose. And they look like this. You see the structure you have read in class 11, biomolecule chapter. So this is the glycosidic bond, alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond. This is glucose. And this is galactose. So this is the lactose, one molecule of glucose and one molecule of galactose from the lactose, which is disaccharide. Now, when the medium contains, let me rub this, when the medium contains, when the medium contains glucose, galactose or lactose, when the medium contain lactose or allolactose, number one, when the medium have very less amount of glucose or no glucose, instead of that, the bacteria will search for an alternative source of energy. And if in absence of glucose, lactose is there, then this lactose, which acts as a lactose sugar, so this is the lactose sugar. This lactose sugar here acts as a inducer. Now this will, when the lactose sugar is there, this will bind with the repressor protein. This is the repressor protein. This will bind with the repressor protein, and when it is binding with the repressor protein, it does not allow the movement of repressor protein to go and bind with the operator region. So repressor protein is now failed to bind with the operator region. Now the operator region is free. Now the operator region is free. As a result, when this repressor protein is kicking away the inducer is kicking away the repressor by binding it with the repressor. So repressor protein is not getting a chance to meet with the operator. And when it is not getting a chance, operator is free. And operator is free, so the RNA polymerase is accessed by the promoter, and the promoter is now allowing the operator to start its operation. What is the operation? It is now allowing the Z, Y and A part of the structural gene to form its mRNA. So this mRNA is now produced. This mRNA is now produced by the three component of structural gene, where Z part of the mRNA is forming a protein, Y part forming another protein, and A part forming another protein. So what is the protein formed by the Z part? This Z part is forming beta galactosidase. Remember it, Z part is forming beta galactosidase. It is a protein in the form of enzyme. It is produced, all enzymes are protein in nature, whereas Y part is forming another protein in the form of enzyme, what we call as permease, and A part is forming another protein in the form of enzyme, that is what we call beta galactosidase transacetylase. So what is the role of this beta galactosidase? Beta galactosidase is the enzyme responsible for breakdown of lactose sugar into glucose and galactose. And now the glucose will be available for the bacteria, and it will obtain its energy. What is the role of permease enzyme? Permease enzyme increases the permeability of the cell membrane to allow the beta galactosidase to go inside it, number one. And number two, the lactose sugar to introduce within the cell from the surrounding medium. So this is the, it helps for increasing the permeability of the cell. And transacetylase, or otherwise called beta galactosidase acetyl transferase, it transfer the acetyl-CoA. So these three enzymes in the form of protein are being transcribed when the repressor protein is binded by the lactose inducer. That means when the lactose is present in the medium, this repressor protein is kicked out by just pulling it from the medium, and as a result ZYNA structural gene are free to produce this enzyme and the lactose sugar is accessible in the medium for the utilization of energy purposes. So this is how the transcription level is being controlled by lactose inducer. That is why we say simply it is lacoperone, otherwise called lactoseperone. So I suppose that you have got a very clear concept about lacoperone, where we have tried to explain jointly, means me and you together, we have learned how the lactose sugar acts as a inducer and not allowing the repressor protein to bind with operator, and operator is free and allowing the ZYNA component of structural gene, polycystronic structural gene, to produce their enzyme, and utilization of lactose is taking place. With this, I hope you have got a very clear concept about the transcription level of a gene expression and the lacoperone module. So thank you for today. See you again in the next class. Thank you.